Okay, what's the casting?
It's the same.
This?
Yes.
Did you just do that?
I did. I don't know.
That's okay, because I'm on pretty early in the program.
No, yeah, that's good. It takes a while to get through the intro.
No, I promise to be quiet.
I don't hear a thing. Oh, maybe this is it.
This is Stan. Anyone pick me up? I guess.
I can hear you.
Hi, Stan.
Can you hear Diane?
We're going to start the service now, everybody. If you would kindly find how to mute your phones or mute your computers, that would be great. Because we have Diane, we have you on the screen, and I think that we want to start this. Good morning. I am Donna Schlachman, a member of the Worship Committee for UU Catskills. Welcome friends, guests, and members to our first service for 2021. Whomever you are, whomever you love, wherever you are in life's journey, you are welcome here. Our minister, the Reverend Dr. Leonisa Artizone, is off this Sunday. Our service is the work of our Director of Music, Catherine Cattabiani, with the support of the Worship Committee. Catherine described this service as one that asks us to consider that it is irrelevant if you see the glass as half empty or half full. What is important is that you know it's always refillable. We hope this is your experience, refilling your glass at UU Catskills. Please remember, those of you on Zoom video can adjust your screens between gallery and speaker view. We hope you'll choose speaker view to give all our special guests your full attention. Also remember to keep yourselves on mute so that you do not accidentally enter the service. If you are starting your new year by visiting us for the first time or returning after a break and you are not yet on our mailing list, please give us your email in the chat box or visit us online at uucatskills.org. We invite everyone to stay for our after service breakout rooms where new people can introduce themselves and meet others and share thoughts of this morning's service. A moment again to Catherine Cattabiani, who crafted today's service, and to our poets and our musical guests for sharing their talents. Also, our thanks to Don Critchell and Kathy Kasner this morning for this morning's Zoom tech wizardry. As always, the Worship Committee asks for your compassion for this technology. Our ability to stream live and pre-recorded materials does not always do them justice. Unitarian Universalism is a non-creedal liberal religion. We are guided in our faith by our seven UU principles. Consistent with these, consistent with these, we are a welcoming congregation for the LGBTQ plus community. We affirm that Black Lives Matter. We are a congregational affiliate of the Ulster Immigrant Defense Network, and we are active voices in the effort to address climate change. Before we join in worship, we have a few announcements this morning. They are also printed in the January newsletter, which you should have gotten in your email or your snail mail. Tomorrow, the Buddha Cats will meet from 5 to 6:30. Kathy Kasner will be leading the meeting, in which they'll discuss a chapter written by Thich Nhat Hanh. If you need the chapter or the Zoom link, you can contact Kathy Kasner at katherinekasner@gmail.com. Tuesday, the Women's Conversation Circle is at 7:30 to 9 p.m. And Pat Hurst can give you more information about that. Thursday, bedtime story and more at 7 p.m. and children and youth of all ages are invited to attend. And Friday, we have our morning yoga. Dr. Reverend Leonisa has chosen imagination as our worship services theme for the month of January. In celebration of a new year and the sense of possibilities that come with it, we've invited some of our congregation's poets and musicians to share their observations and feelings with us. May we all find joy as we imagine the possibilities for this new year. Welcome to UU Catskills. Let us worship together as Bill Toole brings us the prelude, By the Hearth, January, from Peter Tchaikovsky's The Seasons. Thank you, Don. Bill, sorry. Thank you, Bill. Let us join together in lighting our home chalices as we say our chalice lighting words. We light this chalice in grateful, loving community, even in the darkest of times, May its flame light paths to courage, justice, and hope. And let us continue with our unison affirmation. May we be reminded here of our highest aspirations and inspired to bring our gifts of love to all living beings. May we know once again that we are not isolated, but connected in wonder and joy to mystery and miracle in the universe, in this community, and in each other. Our opening words this morning are from UU poet Nancy Beard. Nancy has been a member of UU Catskills since 1996 and recently realized that she started writing around the same time. Perhaps we were the spark for her imagination.
Good morning. We come. Whether we have entered before or we're new through this door, we come. Whether we're young or we're old, shy or so bold, we come. Whether we join in song or choose to march all day long, we come. Whether to care for the earth or to explore our own worth, we come. Whether a candle or chalice we burn to share our joy or express our concern, we come. Whether we call upon God, spirit, goddess, or none of the above, or we choose simply to believe in the power of love, we come. When we give, we receive, and we shall find what we need when we come.
Thank you, thank you. Please, to borrow from Nancy, whether we join in song or choose to march all day long, we come. So we will join in song now. It's dark of winter.
We're not hearing that, Don.
Is my mind woeful grief, and then my soul will sing a song of the sense of the eternal, gentle darkness, soft and still. Bring your
mind.
It's time for Not for Children Only. It's worth repeating, but I'm getting hungry. All right, not for children only. Can you guys see that? Do you know what it is? What it's the picture of? It's a shell, yes. It's a shell of a nautilus. The nautilus isn't there right now, but it normally lives in here. And it is a cephalopod, which means it's in the family of the octopuses and the squid. So it has a soft body and lots of tentacles. As a matter of fact, it has more tentacles than the squid or the octopus. What's different about this particular cephalopod is that it's the only one that has a shell, and it's a beautiful shell. The nautilus can go inside, and it has two very specialized tentacles that it closes over and seals that itself up to keep himself safe. Well, that's an amazing animal right there, but there is something inside that makes it extra special, and I think a lot of the grown-ups know what it is. So if I were to cut it in half, that is what the inside looks like. It's so beautiful. It has these chambers called, and these walls are called septa. As the nautilus grows, and it starts usually with just four little chambers, as it grows, it grows bigger and it moves into the next, it moves up, and then it creates a wall behind it, a septa, as it gets bigger and bigger. So the nautilus that lived here filled this space and was able to squeeze back into it when it wanted to be safe. So they usually start with about four chambers, which is just that little tiny bit when they're first hatched, and they get up to usually around 30. This one is actually 32. It has 32 chambers. So it closes off the old ones and it moves into a new chamber. So we've just entered 2021, and 2020 was pretty rough. So a lot of us are focusing on the concept of sealing off last year, that previous boundary, and creating a new, larger space in which to live and develop. There's a poem called by Oliver Wendell Holmes Sr. called The Chambered Nautilus about this shell, in which he says, grow we must, stressing the need to keep moving and keep developing as we get older. New year, new beginnings, new chances, new chamber. Every day a new beginning. Sometimes when one day has been really, really bad and you wake up the next morning and you go, okay, whatever today brings, I will deal with it. But it is important not to seal off the old chambers. We look it back, we see what happened, we see what we learned. A lot of crazy changes last year, and I think we want to put it behind us, just seal it up and move on. But we also learned a lot in this, with these Zoom services and having to go to school online and all the things we had to do. We learned what we were capable of. We learned how to adapt. We learned to do things differently. What was really important. As we move into our new large chamber of 2021, let's look back and think about what we learned and look ahead with everything we learned and imagine the possibilities. Okay, Donna.
Thank you, Catherine. That was wonderful and a great lead into our time for contemplation and compassion. This is the time for quiet reflection, a time to connect with those in our hearts, to take a moment to breathe into our imaginations, and to let the possibilities ahead seep into our spirits. May each of us pause to refill our figurative glasses, pause for a moment of new beginnings in this quiet space together. We cannot exist without your generous support, both in time and treasures. I'm looking for our offertory slide. This is our time. And our half plate donations for the month of January go to People's Place, a not-for-profit organization feeding, clothing, and responding to the needs of people in Ulster County with kindness, compassion, and the preservation of human dignity since 1972. Let us enjoy Catherine and Ella Cattabiani's recording of Winter Song by Ingrid Michelson and Sarah Bareilles.
My winter song to you. The storm is coming soon. It rolls in from the sea. My voice a beacon in the night. My words will be your light to carry you to me. Is love alive? Is love alive? Is love. Thank you. They say that things just cannot grow beneath the winter snow, or so I have been told. They say we're buried afar, just like a distant star I simply cannot hold. Is love alive? Is love alive? Is love alive?
Okay. Hello, everyone. Can you hear? Okay. My fault. My poem is entitled The Eternal Cycle. It's dedicated to my brother, Randy, who died an untimely death in 1985, which is the pivotal moment in my life. One day, while strolling through a fog, I chanced upon a murky bog, so dark and deep, that life, light which struck its solemn face, penetrated, absorbed without a trace, so life is enveloped by death's dark seep. And yet, the shiny surface sheen reflected all the life that teemed about that marshy shore. And peacefully, surrounded by dismal frill, a tranquil water lily, lay silent, lay still. So life emerges from death once more. Thank you.
She's Nine by Nancy Beard. I look at my daughter, Barbie dolls, dance class, ponytails, headed for the highway sign, birthday parties, little boxes, fuzzy slippers, pointing to the freeway, tiny hair braids, tie-dye shirts, Monopoly. She's almost to the entrance ramp, Girl Scouts, friendship bracelets, flute lessons, to merge into the fast lane. Cute boys, phone calls, flare jeans, with absolutely no clue, ankle bracelets, pony beads, nail polish, about what she's getting into. Pierced ears, Backstreet Boys, lip gloss, by growing up.
Hi, everyone. Six haiku about imagination, and they kind of evolve from dreaming to doing. I'll believe it when I dream it, chrysalis. I'll believe it when I dream it, chrysalis. I imagine a better version of myself, snakeskin in the grass. I imagine a better version of myself, snakeskin in the grass. What changed? What remained the same? Bears leaving the den. What changed? What remained the same? Bears leaving the den. Deep woods, the calls of two barred owls closing the distance. Deep woods, the calls of two barred owls closing the distance. Making amends, the long straight path through the woods. Making amends, the long straight path through the woods. Summer morning, a squirrel renovates the birdhouse. Summer morning, a squirrel renovates the birdhouse.
Lynn Bernstein.
That's not me.
Yes, your turn on writer's block.
That's your picture up there, Don, not mine.
Lynn, just go ahead and read your poem. I know our pictures when we're talking aren't always up there.
Okay.
Thank you.
I pick up my pen to write about turning chenille sweaters, $1 a piece at Goodwill, into fluffy patchwork afghans. I write, the rich, luscious colors call to me from the rack. Plum, pistachio, walnut, cranberry, cinnamon, vanilla, pumpkin, eggplant, mint, butterscotch, cream. Could it be that I'm just hungry? I try again. Seafoam, cerulean, violet, lilac, aqua, sage, and forest green, teal, robin's egg blue, sun gold. I get it now. I'm feeling housebound and need to see the ocean and the sky. Here comes a new wave, jewel tones, garnet, ruby, emerald, jade, amethyst, topaz, alabaster, onyx, ebony, obsidian, pearl. Could it be a secret desire for someone to lavish me with precious jewels? But I already have those, the only ones I ever wanted. My dear ones who will nestle under these love offerings in the cold winter ahead. Maybe the colors will remind them too of food, the outdoors, priceless gems, or of my maternal arms that would rather wrap around them than send Afghans to do the job.
Thank you. No. No. Thank you. We have stepped over that imaginary line into the new year, out of the darkness of the winter solstice and the challenges of 2020 into the increasing light of 2021. We are being given another chance to reimagine our lives, to return to hope, reconnect, rebuild our democracy, refocus, and fill those glasses that felt near empty. Reimagine the possibilities. You may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday you will join us and the world will be as one. For our musical closing words, we will have Ordinary Song, which was written by well-respected Unitarian Universalist composer Elizabeth Alexander.
As we lift our voices on this day, many hearts are heavy with despair. How can our lifted voices find a way to bring us one step closer to repair? If
Nancy, Mary Evans, Mary Stevens, Lynn, and David. We also want to thank especially our technical host, Don Critchell, for taking on a service which was daunting. After our closing benediction, you are invited to stay connected as Don creates the chat rooms. There will be a Children's Chapel chat room today. And may we also suggest that this discussion topic today is the reimagining of the possibilities for 2021. Do you remember the TV series West Wing about a liberal executive branch and a bright, open-minded president who was able to tackle multiple challenges each week? Do you recall sometimes, after meeting numerous trials, just as his staff members were catching their breaths, do you recall what he would say? Okay, what's next? Imagine the possibilities. Please join me as we extinguish our chalices. We extinguish this chalice, but but not the light of truth, the warmth of community, or the fire of commitment. These we carry in our hearts until we are together again. From you I receive, to you I give. Together we share, and from this we live. From you I receive, to you I give. Together we share, and from this we live. I invite you all to go into gallery view so that you can see each other while Don creates our chat rooms. There you can see